Now let's see about this program. C program to calculate total and average by reading 6 subject marks. So we have to read 6 subject marks and we need to calculate total and average. So let the marks are like this. So how many subject marks we have to read? 6 subject marks. So let the marks are some 70, 70, 80, 80, 80. So these are 6 subject marks. Next we have to calculate total and average. So what is the total here? So 70 into 3 means 210, 80 into 3 means 210 plus 240, that is nothing but 450. So what is the average here? 450 by 6, that is nothing but 6 sevens are 42, 65, okay. So the average is equal to 75, okay. So here we can declare marks as some integer type, whereas total and average as some floating point type, or we can declare marks as also some floating point data type. Why? Because marks may be of type float, so we can get some marks as 70.5, 70.2 like that. Okay, so first we have to start from header file declaration. So in this program we have to use this hash include stdio.h. why? Because here we are using printf and scanf functions. Printf and scanf functions are available in stdio.h. Next statement, int main. If the program is successfully executed, then it returns a value called 0. 0 is nothing but integer value. So if you want to return that value, we have to declare the return type as int. So how many subject marks are needed? 6 subject marks. So let us declare it as float. So float m1 comma m2 comma, so 6 subject marks, m3 comma m4 comma m5 comma m6, okay. So 6 variables. Next we need total and average also. So total comma abc. So in this program, what are the input variables? Marks are nothing but input variables. Input variable means we have to supply the marks. Whereas what are the output variables? Output variables means which values we have to display. So which values we have to display here? We have to display total and average. So input variables are nothing but marks, because we need to supply m1, m2, m3, m4, m5, m6. Whereas we need to display total and average. So total average means output variables. Okay. So let us write some printf statement. Printf, enter. So how many subjects we need to read? 6 subjects. So enter 6 subject. Enter 6 subject marks. Enter 6 subject marks. Okay. Next is scanf. Here the format specifier for float is %f. So %f. F stands for float. So it specifies that we are entering some floating point number. We can enter integer number also, there is no problem. Okay. So %f. So how many %f's we have to use? 6 %f's, 3 %f's, 4th %f, 5th %f, 6th %f, comma, %. What is the first variable? M1 comma, %, M2 comma, %, M3 comma, %, M4 comma, %, M5 comma, %, M6. Okay. So reading is over. Next we have to do the calculations. So what is the formula for total? Total is equal to m1 plus m2 plus m3 plus m4 plus m5 plus m6. Next we have to calculate the average. So what is the formula for average? Average is equal to total. Here we have to use this forward slash. In C language or in any programming language, this forward slash specifies division. So we should not write like this. We should not write like this. Okay, this is wrong. So we have to write this. Average is equal to total comma. How many subjects we have? 6 subjects. Okay. Now display total and average. So printf slash n total is equal to. So what is the data type of the total here? Float. For float, the format specifier is %f. %f. And next we have to display average also. The average is equal to. Here we are printing here. For printing, we can use any name here, okay? Here there is no need to use ABC. It is our choice. We can write it as average or ABC or anything here. So average is equal to percentage F comma. For total, the variable name is total. Whereas for average, the variable name is ABC. So printing is over. Next, we have to return 0. Why? Because if the program is successfully executed, then it returns a value called 0. Now let's see how the program will be executed. We know that execution starts from main function. So first he enters if subject mox. This will be displayed on the monitor. So how many values we have to enter now? We have to use a 6 percentage Fs. So we need to enter 6 values. And let the first value is some 70. Second value is some 70. Third value 70. Fourth 180. Fifth 180. Sixth 180. So 70 will be stored in M1. This 70 M2. This 70 M3. 80 M4. 80 M5. 80 M6. So these values are separated with either space bar or enter. Okay. So after entering the 70, we have to use either space bar. Okay. If you use space bar, then after 70, display 70 here. Okay. Don't write by not giving any space. Okay. So we should not enter like this. Okay. So total is equal to M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4 plus M5 plus M6. So what is the total now? So 210 plus 240. That is nothing but 450. So 450.0 will be printed. Okay. Next, what is the formula for average? Average is equal to total by 6. So what is the average here? 75.0. So the output is total is equal to percentage F and average is equal to percentage F comma. So what is first percentage F? Total. What is the total? 450.0 will be printed. Average means 75.0 will be printed. Okay. So in this way we can calculate.